These 50,000 4-week-old Sanko will be selected today. We are at the Marudo Koi Farm, and in this video you will learn how young baby koi are selected and in which way the Japanese breeders decide to select or not select certain koi. In our last video I explained you the breeding process of Nisqy koi. We saw how artificial breeding with koi is prepared and performed, how newly hatched baby koi look like, and how these are released in the mud ponds to grow outside. It is now 4 weeks later. The Sankas successfully grow to around 3 to 4 cm in size. This is the moment where the first Sanbetsu can be performed. Sanbetsu is the name used in Japan for the selection process of koi. So today we are selecting Sanka. Sanka are white koi that have a red with black pattern. The red we call he and the black we call subi. As you can see, the patterns are all different. Some koi are entirely red, others entirely black, and everything in between them. I mention red, but actually it's better to say orange. But in the end, the orange will also become red. But why actually is a breeder selecting his koi? The answer is actually really simple. The breeder doesn't have enough space to let all koi develop under the best circumstances. For that reason, he needs to select his koi. Only the ones that have potential in his or her eyes will be selected. So this mud pound started with 50,000 Sanka, and at the end of the first selection round we will only have around 5,000 Sanka left. That's only 10%. Because less koi in the mud pound means better development, better growth and less risk for diseases. And why in the end would a breeder spend money and time on koi that he will never be able to sell in the end to his clients? So it makes sense that the breeder is selecting only his best koi. And actually everyone is able to learn the aspects where you have to select the koi on. The difficulty is that each variety of koi has their own selection process. But what is common for all varieties of baby koi is that the body posture is not the most important factor to select koi on. While for larger koi, the body counts for at least 50% during the selection process. For now, since the baby koi are only 3 to 4 cm in size, body is just a rough indicator. Even the breeder doesn't exactly know how this will develop in the next upcoming weeks or months. At this moment, the most important factor is the pattern. Even though this is a personal taste, it is important to select on for this moment. The breeder itself doesn't really look for the best patterns here, but mainly if there is actually a pattern visible. For selection of Sanka, the koi must have a white skin visible at certain places. For example, the belly must be white until halfway the body of the koi. It is only allowed to have red and black on the head, preferable between the eyes. The rest of the head should be white. It is important that there is a pattern visible beneath the skin of the koi. So there must be steps in the pattern with white in between and so on. All the Sanka that potentially will develop a pattern according to these basics are selected. Because for now it is just too early to determine if the pattern will actually become nice. This is one of the Sanka we selected that has some more potential. The pattern perfectly lays between the eyes, with white around it. You can clearly see that there are three steps in the red pattern, and the black seems to be nicely divided over the body. This Sanka would be perfect if the end of the body, just before the tail, would be white, which is now completely orange. The koi, however, still has a long way to go, so nobody will really know in the end if it will become a good one. Sanka are one of the most difficult varieties to breed and select. That is actually only for one reason, not because breeding is more difficult or the selection process takes more time, but simply that you cannot select a lot of baby koi. I've selected ponds with around 50,000 Sanka koi fry, and not even 5,000 of these were selected. And that is only in the first selection. The second selection will be around 2 to 3 weeks later, and again only around 10 to a maximum of 20% will be selected. What you can see here is the second Sanbetsu of Sanka baby koi, now almost 7 weeks old, with tremendous growth in the first few weeks. The koi are now around 5 to 7 cm. We were able to select about 50% of this batch of Sanka, which is quite high for a second selection. In the second selection, the pattern is becoming more and more important. The breeders can now start to see if the pattern will become something nice or not. It, however, is still a rough indicator. At this young age, it is impossible to see if the koi will become a future grand champion. I also added some video footage of Kohaku Senbetsu. And I did that to explain that Sanka is way more difficult in comparison with Kohaku. And that is explainable. In the selection of Sanka, way less koi will be selected in comparison with Kohaku. And that reason is actually quite simple. A Sanka is actually a Kohaku with black patterns on it. So not only the Kohaku pattern needs to be right, but also the black dots and patterns on the Kohaku pattern need to be nice. So that means double the complexity and double the chance that a koi won't have a good pattern. Also during the first selection of Kohaku, the most important aspect is the pattern. And mainly technical aspects of the pattern are taken into account. And these include, for example, that the red pattern, preferable, does not cover the entire head. And at the same time, the head should not be entirely white. The nose should be white, and there should be white visible around the head. Preferable, the red pattern lays between the eyes, same as for Sanka. The last part of the body, just before the tail, should be white as well. This is called the odome. And the fin should not be red, including the tail and the dorsal fin. And that doesn't mean if one of the baby koi does not match these criteria that they won't be selected at all. For the first round, it is still okay if not everything is matching for 100% the technical aspects. And you should know that after the selection, the koi are released again to the mud bounds, growing larger and waiting for the next selection round. In the first year, there will be around 5 to 6 rounds of selections for Sanka. Imagine out of the 50,000 Sanka, how many will be left. If lucky, a few hundred ones that can be sold. And if lucky enough, a handful of high quality Sanka that can be sold for a good profit. Hopefully you liked and enjoyed the video. Please comment below or like and consider to subscribe to our YouTube channel. See you in the next episode.